Hello, you're on PubloSpot. I'm George. Welcome to another episode on exploring layers of handling web requests. Today is a day that I'll be setting up AWS Load Balancer as a web proxy. Today is a show and tell on how to use AWS Load Balancer as a port forwarder for my sample web application. And so if this series and the content of this channel lines up with your interests, hit the subscribe button and join me in this journey of learning by doing. So, let's start coding. As always, I'm going to start with making sure that I have the latest copy of the code in my local machine. And then today, I'll create a new branch for my changes. In the previous episode, which you can access right here, I set up an EC2 instance that runs Docker containers for my Nginx web proxy, along with my web application. Today, I'll be putting AWS Load Balancer as another layer of web proxy that will forward the request to my EC2 instance. So to start, let me list down the things that I need to accomplish today. So this is my task list. Let me start with the first task, creating a separate directory for Load Balancer Terraform code. So if I open my Explorer, I'm going to create a new directory in the root of my repository and call it LB for Load Balancer. And then I'm going to open my terminal and then cd to this new directory. And then I'm going to run my script to create my Terraform code shell. So that's done. Now let me verify that my Terraform shells are in place. So if I open my Explorer, all my files are there. I also need to make sure that I use Terraform Cloud for my setup, so I'll update my backend at TF. And that's my first task done. So let me go back to my task list. Now I'm going to move to the next two tasks, which involves creating a publicly accessible load balancer and at the same time attaching a security group to that load balancer to allow inbound access to ports 8080 all the way to 8082 from public. So let me open my load balancer Terraform code and open my main.tf. So this is my load balancer resource. I set the internal property to false to indicate that this will be accessible from the internet. I need to attach a security group on this load balancer to allow public access on ports 8080 all the way up to 8082. As you can see, this resource has an ingress block to allow inbound requests for ports 8080 to 8082. And for simplicity, I have set a full outbound accessibility with the egress block. And so I can now attach this security group to my load balancer resource. I also need to set the subnets property on this load balancer. I'll be creating my load balancer inside my default VPC, so I need to set a reference to this resource. This is one of a few special Terraform resource blocks. In here, I'm not actually creating a new VPC resource, but this is how Terraform allows me to reference the default VPC that comes with my AWS account. And now I can set up a data reference to pull out all the subnets associated to this default VPC. So on my data.tf, and so I can then update the subnets property on my load balancer resource to point to this data reference. So back to my main.tf. And that's my load balancer resource. So let me head back to my list and move to the next task. I need to create a container for my resource that eventually processes the web request. In my case, this will be my EC2 instance from the previous episode. So let me switch back to my main.df for my load balancer Terraform code and start writing the code. I want to create target group resource for each port that my web apps are accessible from. So instead of creating three different blocks, I will create my resource using the for each property. The for each property means I'll create a target group resource for each element on my list. For each works only with a key value pair, which is why I use to set to convert my list to a set object. And then I'll reference each element on my list by using each.key and use the value for my port. And for the VPC property, I will point this to my default VPC resource ID. And that's it for my target group resource. So I'm going to go back to my task list. The next task is attaching my EC2 instance to my target group resource. So back to my load balancer main.tf. I also need this resource to be created for each port, like my target group resource. And so I need to use the same for each approach. With this for each property, I can then use the key to reference the applicable target group ARN that I can use. The target ID property needs to point to my EC2 instance that I've set up from the previous episode. So what I need to do is set a data reference that will point to this EC2 instance. So on my data.tf, when I wrote my Terraform code for my EC2 previously, I have set the name tag. And this is what I will use to filter out the EC2 instance. I can then use a data reference to this block on my target group attachment. So back to my main.tf. And that's another task done. So now let me go back to my list and check what else needs to be done. The last set of tasks include attaching my target group to my load balancer by creating listener resources and outputting the load balancer DNS that I will use to verify that everything works. So back to my main.tf. I need to set the load balancer ARN property to point to my load balancer resource. I need this resource created for each port that my web applications run on. And so I need to use for each block for this resource to align with how I created my target group resources. I'm going to use each key to assign the value for my port and use this same key to fetch the appropriate target group ARN resource. And last but not the least, update the output.tf to display my load balancer DNS. Now let me head back to my task file and clear out my list. And this is now the time to stand up my load balancer infrastructure. So let me open my terminal and export my AWS credentials and my Terraform workspace. And then I need to make sure that I am inside the LB directory, which I am, and then start running Terraform init. This error indicates that I don't have workspace created yet in Terraform Cloud. So I'll create my workspace by running this. Before running Terraform plan and apply, I need to change the execution mode of my new workspace to local. So on my browser, I'm going to head over to Terraform Cloud and open the workspace that I just created, which is right here. Go to Settings, General, and scroll all the way to the section that says Execution Mode and change that to Local. And now if I switch back to my VS Code, I now need to rerun my Terraform init and then run Terraform plan. And now I'm going to run Terraform apply. So my Terraform apply is successful And so my load balancer infrastructure is now up. So let me go ahead and copy this LBDNS output here. And then switch to my browser. And then I'm going to verify port 8080 against this load balancer, which, as expected, loads my Nginx web application. Now, if I'm going to try port 8081, it loads my Sonar web application. So far, so good. And then lastly, port 8082. And it also loads my Radar application. That's it for today's episode. As a friendly reminder, don't forget to destroy your infrastructure if you don't need them anymore. On the next episode, I will make the necessary changes to make my load balancer resources more manageable and also set up path-based routing, so stay tuned. In the meantime, let me know your thoughts in the comments below and send me some likes if you find this useful. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you like my content and help me spread the word about this. Until next time, keep learning and stay safe.